Welcome. Hello, I'm Chaplain David Thompson with the St. Lucie County Sheriff's Office, and I'm going to do the opening prayer today for our annual law enforcement memorial service for 2021. So let's go to God briefly if you bow your head for a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we lift up this occasion as we come together to remember the 14 fallen officers that have died in the line of duty here in St. Lucie County. Lord, we thank you for their bravery and their heroism, which was displayed in the lives they lived. And we ask a special blessing on this occasion as we remember them, honor their lives, and also say a special prayer for their families. As always, Lord, we ask you to watch over, protect our law enforcement community here in St. Lucie County, and let your peace, your power, your presence, and your love be with them now and forevermore. Amen.
I'm Sheriff Ken Mascara. The disciple Matthew says, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God." There are only a few days in which our federal government mandates the lowering of flags to half staff. Two of those days are in May, Memorial Day, that's the last Monday in May, in which we honor and remember those who have made the supreme sacrifice while serving in the armed services, and Peace Officers Memorial Day, in which we honor and remember law enforcement officers who have made the supreme sacrifice or who have been disabled in the line of duty. This Thursday night is the annual National Law Enforcement Candlelight Vigil in Washington, D.C., where more than 300 names of heroes who have made the ultimate supreme sacrifice will be added to the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial Wall. Here in St. Lucie County, our agency has 8 heroes who have made the supreme sacrifice while serving our community. They are Daniel S. Carlton, the second sheriff of St. Lucie County, who died May 22, 1915, after a shootout in the middle of the business district in Fort Pierce. He was the first member in the history of the St. Lucie County Sheriff's Office to be killed in the line of duty. William Robert Monroe, our agency's fourth sheriff, died on March 25, 1921, after seizing a cabin cruiser loaded with illegal liquor. The boat exploded, killing him instantly and injuring 2 other deputies. Soren A. Sorensen died on March 20, 1935, following a motorcycle accident 6 days earlier. Sergeant Harold F. Holliger died August 26, 1985, after he took a part-time retirement position as a school crossing guard and was struck and killed by a motor vehicle. The firearms training range was named the Sergeant Harold F. Pappy Hollinger Range in his honor. Master Deputy Steve Roberts died March 3, 1999, following a traffic accident involving his patrol motorcycle. The Sheriff's Office on Midway Road has been renamed and dedicated as the Master Deputy Steve Roberts Building in memory of his service. Master Deputy Joseph S. Hover died on October 8, 2005, as a result of a defensive tactics training injury. The Sheriff's Office Curtis King Boulevard substation has been dedicated as the Master Deputy Joseph S. Hover Substation in his honor of his service. Sergeant Gary Morales was killed on February 28, 2013, when he conducted a traffic stop on a suspect just south of Fort Pierce following a brief pursuit. The Sheriff's Office training facility was renamed the Sergeant Gary Morales Training Complex in honor of his memory and his passion for training. Last, Captain Charles Scavuzzo died from a massive heart attack on Friday, September 15, 2017, just days after Hurricane Irma's damaging winds, storm surge, and rain bands struck our area on September 10th. The agency's Special Investigation Office was renamed the Captain Charlie Pancho Scavuzzo Special Investigation Bureau in his honor. A memorial wall inside the Sheriff's Office headquarters honors these fallen heroes. On it is inscribed, "Those we love don't go away. They walk beside us every day. Unseen, unheard, but always near, still loved, still missed, and very dear. May we always remember these heroes and their dedication to our community."
Hi, I am Chief Diane Hobley-Burney of the Fort Pierce Police Department. I am so honored to be here before you today to honor the heroes that made the ultimate sacrifice of their lives for the safety of our community. It is so hard and very difficult for myself, and I am sure the families, in having to honor our officers this way. But as we know, being a police officer comes with many risks, not only to put on the uniform, but to be a part of the safety of you for today as well as tomorrow. Today, it gives me great honor to honor our heroes who gave that ultimate sacrifice for the Fort Pierce Police Department. Our first officer is Officer Willie B. Ellis, who died in the line of duty on July 17, 1966, at the age of 43. Officer Ellis and his partner, Officer Clifford Miners, were handling a domestic violence call when the suspect grabbed Officer Ellis' pistol and opened fire on both officers. Officer Miners was seriously injured, but survived. Officer Ellis did not. And tragically, he became the first Fort Pierce police officer to lose his life in the line of duty. Officer Ellis was promoted to the rank of sergeant following his death in honor of his service. In 2000, Willie B. Ellis substation in Fort Pierce was dedicated in his honor. Lieutenant Grover C. Cooper III, 31, and Detective James A. Walters, 33, died in the line of duty on January 12, 1987. During the incident, officers from the Department's Special Investigations Unit and the St. Lucie County Sheriff's Office were conducting a drug investigation at a home in White City. As officers attempted entry, the suspect opened fire, striking Lieutenant Cooper under continuing assault by gunfire. Detective Walters were able to fatally wound the suspect, but not before he and Officer Robert Spring also suffered gunshot wounds. Officer Spring was seriously injured, but survived. Lieutenant Cooper and Detective Walters did not survive, and tragically, they became the second and third Fort Pierce police officers to die in the line of duty. Captain Cooper and Sergeant Walters were both promoted to these ranks in honor of their service. Our police station on US 1 has been dedicated as the Glover C. Cooper III and James A. Walters main station in their honor. Officer Danny Parrish died in the line of duty on January 19, 1991 at the age of 29. Officer Parrish was on a routine patrol in Fort Pierce when he stopped the car for going the wrong way on a one-way street. The driver, an 18-year-old repeat offender, feared that he would be arrested for not having a driver's license and assaulted Officer Parrish. In the struggle, the suspect grabbed Officer Parrish's gun and shot him 13 times. Although he was wearing a bullet-resistant vest, Officer Parrish died from multiple gunshot wounds. Officer Parrish was promoted to the rank of sergeant following his death in honor of his service. We are planning a memorial to honor him at a later date. Today, all of our officers wear the names of these four officers inscribed on our badge so that we never forget the ultimate sacrifice that each of these men made. All of us serve in their honor and their memory. God bless.
I'm Chief John Bolduc with the Port St. Lucie Police Department. On behalf of the men and women of the Port St. Lucie Police Department, I'd like to thank you for taking time to join us for the annual Law Enforcement Memorial Service. Each year during Police Memorial Week, we pause and gather to remember those who gave their life in service to their communities. Under normal circumstances, Police Memorial Week provides an opportunity for fellowship, a rekindling of the brotherhood, which makes policing so fraternal. The term brotherhood is defined as a fellowship in an alliance or an association for a particular purpose, and that purpose is public safety. But today, in the interest of public safety, we cannot gather together and mourn, lean on each other, and support the families of our fallen as we have traditionally done. Due to the pandemic, COVID-19, in the interest of public safety, we should not gather. We should stay socially distanced. And so, as we pause and show respect, let us not be victimized by the circumstances of this temporary situation in which the entire world has been battling for the past year. Let us show the fortitude and the resilience and carry on as we have before. And in the name of protecting a free society, let us respect each other and continue to practice social distancing, yet ensure that those who have lost the most know we care, we are here, and we support them. Since the first known line of duty death in 1791, there have been over 21,000 officers killed in the line of duty. 29 years ago, May 13, 1992, Sergeant Don Mahan, a motorcycle officer, became the first Port St. Lucie officer killed in the line of duty. The department has changed and grown since Sergeant Mahan's death, and now very few members of our department knew or worked with Donnie Mahan, including myself. This is why it is so important to have this memorial service each year to honor Sergeant Donald Mahan for his service, to honor his family and their sacrifice to keep his memory alive. 6 years ago, the department created a memorial wall to pay tribute to the sacrifices of the Mahan family. We vow to never forget the sacrifice made by the Mahan family. Sergeant Mahan was born on September 6, 1959 in Natrona Heights, Pennsylvania. A seasoned police officer in Pennsylvania, he relocated to Florida in 1989. He served with the Riviera Beach Police Department, where he also served as a motor officer prior to joining the Port St. Lucie Police Department on February 4, 1991. In the late evening hours on May 12, 1992, while responding to a multi-vehicle crash on U.S. Highway No. 1, Sergeant Mahan was struck by a passing motorist. Seriously injured at the scene, he succumbed to his injuries a few hours later on May 13, 1992. Sergeant Mahan left behind his wife, Kelly, 18-month-old son, Bradley, and 6-week-old daughter, Courtney, as well as his parents, Donna and Priscilla Mahan, and his sister, Lori. This tragic incident resulted in the death of a young, energetic officer with tremendous promise, the loss of a son, a father, a husband, and a friend to many. Nearly 2 years ago, on June 12, 2019, Officer Stephen James Brown passed away at his home following his shift. Police Officer Stephen Brown suffered a fatal heart attack after completing a third day of leading the Port St. Lucie Police Athletic League police camp. He was one of the camp leaders as part of his summertime duties as a school resource officer. The camp involved 3 days of strenuous outdoor activities, including an obstacle course at the Navy UDT Seal Museum. Officer Brown collapsed after returning home at the end of his shift on June 12. Officer Brown had served the Port St. Lucie Police Department for 14 years. He is survived by his wife Maria, son Nicholas, and his daughter Isabella. Officer Brown's name was added to the wall at the National Memorial during Police Week last year, but due to the pandemic, a public service was not held. Steve's has been added to the memorial wall inside the department to ensure future officers and residents and visitors remember the Brown family sacrifice to this community. As we pause today in remembrance of Sergeant Don Mahan and Officer Steve Brown, let us remember the sacrifice made by the families such as ours 343 times last year across this great country. Of those 343 line of duty deaths listed on the Officer Down Memorial page for 2020, 222 related to COVID-19. In addition to our line of duty deaths, we have lost several other co-workers to illness over the years. All of these men and women were dedicated to making Port St. Lucie the safest community possible. They are all greatly missed among our ranks. Today, as we pause, our hearts are heavy with the loss, yet filled with love and support for the families and friends of those who are no longer with us. As you pause and remember Donnie and Steve and our other fallen brothers and sisters, take comfort in recalling that they dedicated their lives to the same principles of honor, duty, and service that brought you to the badge. Such a life is truly rich. Take strength in knowing that when an officer falls, our resolve to serve those in need is not diminished. Do not succumb to the wishes of those who wish to dishonor you. Quietly go about making the world a better place, the way you always have. Today, more than ever, it is imperative that we remain vigilant in the face of our challenges. Continue to honor the sacrifices which have been made by serving the community with honor. Watch over your brother and sister officers. Let us put our petty differences aside, keep each other safe, focused, and balanced. We must also continue to wear this uniform with pride, proud of our department, proud of our fine city, as we protect and serve the citizens each day with courage, knowledge, and integrity.
Hello, my name is Ryan Lloyd, and I am the captain and district commander for the Florida Highway Patrol here on the Treasure Coast. It is a solemn honor that the Florida Highway Patrol has been included in this year's ceremony to commemorate and remember the local officers who lost their lives in the line of duty. They are all heroes. Each day, law enforcement personnel all across our nation, whether employed by local, state, tribal, or federal agencies, face untold dangers while performing our various duties. Some officers pay the ultimate sacrifice, and it is important that we remember them for all time during ceremonies just like this. On February 5, 2020, tragedy struck the Florida Highway Patrol when Trooper Joseph Bullock responded to a disabled motorist on I-95. During the incident, the motorist became angry and fatally shot Trooper Bullock in the head with a handgun. The suspect then attempted to shoot a tow truck driver who was also on scene. An off-duty Riviera Beach police officer saw the disturbance as he was traveling southbound on I-95 and he returned to the scene. The Riviera Beach police officer exchanged gunfire with the suspect and the suspect was shot in the chest. The suspect then turned his own handgun on himself and committed suicide from a self-inflicted gunshot wound. Trooper Bullock was a member of the Florida Highway Patrol's 99th recruit class, and he served on the Treasure Coast throughout his entire 19-year law enforcement career. Prior to joining the patrol, Bullock honorably served as a United States Air Force veteran. On February 5, 2021, a one-year commemoration ceremony was held on the Treasure Coast to honor Trooper Bullock. In accordance with approved Florida legislation, a portion of I-95 was memorialized and dedicated in honor of Joe's sacrifice, and the Florida Highway Patrol Troop L Fort Pierce Station was renamed the Trooper Joseph Bullock Building. Finally, in early 2021, the President of the United States signed federal legislation, which was presented by U.S. Congressman Brian Mast, to rename the Port Salerno Post Office in honor of Trooper Bullock. This ceremony will occur on a future date. Trooper Bullock's untimely death while serving in the line of duty is still fresh in our minds and our hearts. It was an honor and joy to have served with him. Anyone who knew Joe will always remember his larger-than-life personality and his infectious laugh. Moving forward, let us never forget the ultimate sacrifices that many of our beloved police officers have made while making the Treasure Coast a safer community to live in. Thank you.
Let's bow our heads as we do a closing prayer on this occasion. Father God, we thank you for the lives that we have honored, these 14 men that were not heroes because of the way they died, but they were heroes because of the way they lived. We thank you for their commitment to serve and protect our community. We thank you for the ultimate sacrifice that they made so that we could be safe. And we pray again for a hedge of protection around our law enforcement community as they go out every day to serve and protect our community. We also pray for our command staff, our sheriff, our police chiefs, and Captain Lloyd with the Florida Highway Patrol. Thank you for your very present help for them in these troubling times. And we pray this prayer in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good. uniformed personnel, present arms. Personnel, order, arms.
Oh, Val, face